illustrious cantorial colleagues, and we share your joy as you reach this most awesome and amazing milestone in your lives. To your rabbinic colleagues, and to your families, and to your friends, and to your mentors, we wish you mazel tov as well. Today we have all struggled to find the right words. This day so full of joy is darkened with our sad and tragic loss. But we spend much of our lives perched precariously on the fulcrum of the scales of joy and sorrow, struggling to find balance. And the truth is, as clergy, you will have many days like this. This life's calling will give you days where great personal joy will collide dramatically with deep collective sadness, and days where you will be called to celebrate with your community when you yourself might be struggling. But you are prepared for these days. You can and you will dig deep into your soul. You will gather your strength and you will sing your hearts out. An American novelist said, "Music isn't just a pleasure, a transient satisfaction. It's a need, it's a deep hunger. And when the music is right, it's joy and it's love. A foretaste of heaven, a comfort in grief. And is it too much to think that perhaps God speaks to us through music?" Last night, as social media filled with memories and pictures, my own year in Israel class found some comfort in the virtual community of our group chat. And you are the class of 2018, and no matter how far you land from each other, no matter how diverse your paths become, no matter how different your individual cantorates may be, you are bound together by this collective identity. Today you make the transition from classmates to colleagues, but remain friends. Rely on each other, encourage and support each other. You have traveled this marvelous journey to this day, and like siblings, you have experiences and memories that only you share. This is a gift, and it will continue to sustain you for the years to come. And so now you trade classrooms for offices, and you, my cantors, will create new choirs from new voices that will work so very hard to sing along with you. You will have what I refer to as Dr. Seuss Onik Shabbat. You sing too high, you sing too low, you sing too fast, you sing too slow. You sang a song I did not know. But understand that these people who comment on your music are trying so desperately to connect to you and to speak your language. You set out to new places. You carry your unique gifts to the communities, and oh, they can't wait to welcome you. So those interesting Onik conversations, they will find their balance too. Because you will have moments when you look up from your lectern and you see in the back a row of 12 and 13 year olds dancing in their seats with the correct rhythm. Or when you notice that somebody's gaze is transfixed upon you as you sing a melody of their past. Or you see that someone with a single tear rolling down their cheek. Let these powerful moments remind you of the gift you have been given with this sacred calling. The ability to connect people to all that is meaningful and beautiful about Judaism, and to bring them closer to God with your voice and with your soul. To paraphrase the lovely rabbi who I spoke with this morning, who said, "I don't have the words, but I think maybe you have the melody. Maybe that's a better gift." So you have your melody, you have your gift, go out and share it with the world. Mazel tov.